A crowd gathers to view the body of a man in southwest Cameroon. He's the latest victim of fighting between separatist and government forces. A government clampdown on separatists has dominated headlines here, ever since teachers and lawyers in the English-speaking region refused to work in French, leading to calls to secede from Cameroon in 2016. Martha fled her hometown after a security operation. She says soldiers forced their way into her home as they sought information on separatists.
They saved me, I no talk true.
Soldiers came to our home at night and brought out a photo, asking me if I knew the person in it. I told them I cannot recognize the person in the photo. The soldiers told me that if I don't tell them the truth, I will be shot together with my mother. They had surrounded my mother and me. My mother collapsed, and they forced the door. The door fell on me, and I fell down.
Another victim is recovering in hospital. Daniel says soldiers opened fire on his home.
The next thing I saw was a fire. My house was set ablaze, so I had to climb to the ceiling for safety. The fire kept coming towards me, so I struggled and I jumped to the next room.
He escaped the flames after the soldiers left but suffered burns. Cameroon has a population of about 24 million people. Most speak French, but about 5 million are English speakers. The Anglophones say the government has discriminated against them and they want their own state. Over 10,000 English speakers have fled to neighboring Nigeria because of the government crackdown. The government has denied its forces have attacked civilians, but with allegations of brutality by its forces surfacing, it's clear many of the refugees won't be returning home anytime soon. Abdi Osman, TRT World.